Hi, I'm DJ Dino from Jinx Games, and this tutorial is about how you can raycast bullet holes and use pooling. But first, I would like to thank everyone who purchased my PlayMaker samples on the asset store. I would also like to ask if you could rate my asset and maybe give a review. Again, thank you. Okay, so let's get started. I'm using Pooler, and you can find this on the asset store, but it's pretty limited actually, but it's okay for this tutorial. So you might use a different kind of pool system. And what I'm doing here is set up some pools and initiate some objects from bullet hole 1, and I do the same for bullet hole 2 and bullet hole 3. Then let's go on the player, and here I have my shoot FSM. And the first thing I do here is my get mouse button down. So when I press my mouse, I'm gonna do something. And I'm gonna raycast. And I'm gonna raycast from the weapon tip. And the weapon tip is in my camera actually, because I'm doing the rotation with my camera. And it's also not set on the tip from the weapon actually, but on the center from the camera, straight forward, because I want it to match on my crosshair. So that's why it's centered there. So the raycast is gonna start from there, and it's gonna raycast in the direction C, and it's gonna be forward. Then on space self and a distance of 100. The distance also depends on your weapons, of course, and on your own setup. Then I have a hit event and a no hit event. And actually, I use Raycast 2, and you can also find it on the ecosystem, because this has this no hit event, and I like to have this, so that's why I use this one. And I think that's about the only difference with a normal raycast. Then I store the hit object. And I'm storing the object because I want to know what tag the object has. So if I hit the roof, I know that it's going to be a roof because I have a roof tag. Then I store the hit point, and that's going to be the position where the raycast hit. And then I'm storing the hit normal. And that's going to be the rotation from the object where it hit. So then when I don't hit anything, I just go back here, next frame, and go back to the mouse listener. So when I hit something, then I'm going to first check here my array. So I have an array where I'm going to store all my bullet holes. And if it's reached 20, then it's a maximum bullet holes, and then I should remove one of the holes, and that's to prevent lag. And so in here, then if I need to remove something, I have this array get, and I'm gonna get from index 0 the object, then I'm gonna delete that from index 0. And then I also gonna destroy the stored, and actually you're not destroying but disabling. So that's why the pooler. Then let's go back here. So if it's less than 20, we can just go here. And then we're gonna check if it's the roof. Because on the roof, I made it so that I only want one kind of bullets. And on the other places, I do just a random. So that's why I do this tag compare. You can also use a tag switch if you have multiple objects and you want different textures for each object. All is possible. Just expand this with several options if you wish. That's all up to you, but I kept it a little bit more simple. So if I hit the roof, I'm just gonna set this string bullet hole 2, and if I didn't hit the roof, I'm gonna get a random string, and that's gonna be bullet hole 1, bullet hole 2, bullet hole 3. And I'm storing this in this pool string variable. then I'm going to spawn it. And the first thing I'm going to do here is this quaternion look rotation. And this is actually to get the exact rotation. Because if you would just get this hit normal and just use the rotation to spawn it, then you wouldn't get the right rotation. So that's why I use this quaternion look rotation. So that's gonna give them the good result. But this is also giving a quaternion, and it's not giving a standard rotation. So I can't do this directly with this puller spawn. And that's why I use the set rotation below. But let me explain first the puller spawn. So the spawn, I have the name of the pool, and that's going to be this pool variable. So if I have if I hit the roof, it's going to be that bullet hole 2. And else it's going to be a random 1, 2, or 3. And then I use the hit point for the position. And the rotation, I do nothing. But I am storing the object, so I can still do something else to that object. And that's what I'm doing here. So here I have this stored object, and I use this quaternion rotation. So what I did here, the store hit normal, and the result is rotation. And place this here in the quaternion and in space world. And I have to do this only once, so no every frame. Then I have this array add, and I'm going to store the bullet hole that I spawned here. I'm going to store that in this bullet holes array. So that's just to know if there are 20 objects, and also to disable the objects in here. So here, delete add from the gold bullet holes. And so every time the last one gonna be destroyed or disabled. And once I spawned it, I go to next frame and go back to the mouse listener. That's it. So let me just play this once. So shooting here, and here you can see they all stay the same. And you see also they are going away after 20 hits. And of course you can adjust that, and also you can later on make it with some animations that they fade out and stuff, but yeah, that's all up to you. Okay, now we're gonna need to use an offset, else our image can be inside the wall and you get a flickering effect, or sometimes you don't see the bullet holes at all. So that's why we need to have it a little bit in front of the wall or the object. And there are two ways that I'm using, and one of them is just on the prefab. So I'll show you the prefab here. That's just an empty object, and inside of that I have my plane with my image on it, and I have the rotation X set to 90, but it's possible that you need to have a different rotation. And I have my position Z to 0.0002, and this will make it that it's gonna be a little bit in front. But we can also do this in a different way, and then we set this to 0.000, and now you would have the problem again. But we can go here to the spawn bullet hole, and we're gonna add some actions, and let me just look for them. So vector 3 operator, and then vector 1 is going to be store hit normal, and then vector 2 we're going to set 0.0002, then multiply. And we're gonna resolve this at 2 hit point. Then we're gonna do another action. Vector 3 add. And on the store hit point, we're going to add this add to hit point. So it's going to add a little bit on each direction, actually, because I don't know immediately which side is going to be the front. So if I only put Z to 0.0002, it could be that when I shoot on the floor, I still gonna have this issue. So that's why you need to do it on all. So actually your decal is gonna be moved in three ways, but it's just so small that with the eye you cannot see the difference. So that's another way. And I will just play this so you can see that this works. So that looks good. On the floor looks good. Then let me turn this off. And then you can see the difference. And now you can see this is the effect we don't want to have. So that's how we can make bullet holes.
Thank you for watching. If you liked the tutorial, please like the video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. You can support my work by becoming a patron at Patreon, or donate me with PayPal, or purchase my assets on the asset store. You can find the links in the descriptions below.